Hello everybody, welcome to Magic in My Food. This is Jyoti Dalmia. On Tuesday, I posted a healthy non-keto recipe, that is your fruit popsicles. So this motivated me for this Friday to post keto popsicles. Why should I be left behind without any popsicle just because I'm following keto diet? So here comes awesome recipes of keto popsicles. They are actually mind-blowing. You can never imagine. You know what are the flavors like? It's like Panipuri flavor keto popsicle, Dahi papdi flavored keto popsicles, Jal Jeera flavored, which is not a sweet, keto popsicles, and your rose Lassi keto popsicles. Yes, these are the four popsicles I'm making today, and these are all keto popsicles, and you can enjoy it and beat this summer heat. So let's begin with it without wasting any time. So we are going to prepare these Indian street food type of popsicles, you can say. They are actually Indian street foods. So now we are making Jal Jeera popsicles. So for this, take a mixing bowl, add chaat masala to it, add rock salt to it, add roasted cumin powder and lemon. A big quantity of lemon juice goes into it. If you have small lemons, then add more. Add water to it. Now add coriander leaves and I'm going to stir it. Just stir it and my mixture is ready. I'm just tasting. It's quite good, yummy, very tangy flavor. And now my Jal Jeera juice, I'm going to just transfer it into a glass. I'm transferring the mixture into a glass so that it's much easier to pour. And I'm transferring it into a popsicle stand. Any shape, since I had the kulfi or the round shape, I'm using that one. If you don't have, just fill it up properly and I'm covering it up. See, my Jal Jeera popsicles are ready to be taken to the fridge. And now we'll prepare the Dahi Papdi popsicles. So for the Dahi Papdi popsicles, I'm going to first make the papdis. So for the papdis, I'm using the cheese slice. Yes, those cheese crispies will act as papdis. So for this, I've already sliced. You can see you have to make small pieces. I'm just showing you how it is done. Just, I actually need only one slice of cheese. But for the sake of showing you, I'm slicing it again and I'm spreading it out. Just slice it into small pieces and spread it out. It takes about 2 to 3 minutes, not more than that. And now this will go into the microwave. So I'm going to just microwave it for 1 minute. And after microwaving, let it stand for at least 30 seconds or 1 minute and it will become crispy. Now I'm removing it from the parchment paper and transferring it into a small bowl. So my papdis are ready. Now take a mixing bowl. I'm preparing the Dahi Papdi popsicles. So I've added hung curd to it. Now goes your fresh cream goes into it. You can add whipped cream even. That would also give a very good creamier texture. But I found this one was worth it. Now I'm adding erythritol. That is my sweetener. You can add whatever sweetener you like, whichever you are using. Some roasted cumin powder goes into it. That will give the awesome taste to this Dahi Papdi chaat. Some red chilli powder goes into it. Here some rock salt goes into it. And I'm going to mix it up thoroughly. Mix it up properly so that it becomes a homogeneous mixture. Now I'm adding your coriander, finely chopped coriander leaves. Lovely, I'm just tasting it. I think so, I cannot resist. I want to see what is the taste and it is awesome. So now this mixture is ready. I am going to drop some of the cheese slices, the cheese crispies actually. These are my papdis. So I'm dropping some of the papdis into it. Now I'm going to drop the mixture into the popsicle stand. So that one was the jaljeera popsicle. Now goes my dahi papdi popsicles. These are the papdis I've used. I'm just dropping the mixture and I'm going to cover it up. This mixture makes about 4 popsicles. All the variety, they make 4 popsicles each. So if you want to make 8 or 10, just increase the quantity. Now this stand will go into the deep freezer to get freezed. Now is the turn of the rose lassi popsicles. These are my fresh, lovely rose petals. I'm just going to churn it. So after churning, it looks like this. Now I'm going to transfer this finely chopped rose petals into a bowl. This would give a lovely taste to the rose lassi popsicles. I'm adding hunk curd to it. Here goes fresh cream. Now add erythritol, good quantity of erythritol, or the sweetener goes into it. Whatever sweetener you like, you can add. I am adding erythritol. And some rose water. You can add rose essence even, or the kevra flavor, whatever you like. I wanted to add rose water only. So I've added the rose water and I'm mixing it up thoroughly so that the erythritol gets easily mixed up properly into the mixture. So mix it up thoroughly. It will take about one minute at least. And now I'm going to drop the mixture into the popsicle stand. I'm just going to cover it up and my rose lassi popsicle is ready. It will go into the deep freezer to freeze. One thing I forgot to say, you should always wet the mold before putting any mixture into it so it becomes easier for it to come out. So now comes the final Panipuri popsicle. This is too delicious. For this, I have taken the mint leaves, added some ginger, some green chilli goes into it, and erythritol goes into it. And I'm going to churn this. Before churning, I'm going to add water to it. Add little water, and we'll add the remaining water afterwards. See, after churning, it looks like this. I'm transferring the mixture into a bowl. So you can see I'm adding more water to the mixer only. Just rotate it so that all the remaining portion also comes out. Going to add the remaining water. Add roasted cumin powder to it. Don't forget, this is your panipuri. Add some rock salt. This is a delicious. You can drink it like this. And the same goes for the rose lassi even. I've added red chilli powder. Here goes the lemon. Motion got deleted, so I have reshooted again. So sorry for that. And I'm going to just mix it up. So after mixing, I'm going to pour it into the mold, and after pouring, now this will go into the deep freezer. After 3-4 hours, see, I'm just taking it out. Lovely. I can't resist the smell of the mint, you know, it's so freshening. So my panipuri popsicles are done. So enjoy whichever flavor you like. Either the dahi papri popsicles, or the fruit lassi popsicles, or the jaljeera tangy salty popsicles, or the sweet and tangy panipuri popsicles. So if you have liked it and enjoyed it, Please viewers, like and subscribe to my channel and please post comments and queries. I would love to answer it. Thank you.